that prayer or not?
Not yet.
Do you need some more music? Do you need some more music?
Yes, just one more piece.
One more piece. Trumpet bottle here. What page is that?
Three.
Page three. Page three. One, two, three, go.
nothing in this world could ever make me walk away. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what you face, you'll never be lonely. Because forever is a long time. That's how long I love you. That's how long I love you. Ever. Forever is a long time. That's how long I love you. That's how long I love you. Forever. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what you face, never be lonely. This is my promise to you, and I'll leave you never. You can count on me to be there always. Forever, oh, forever is
perfect.
Amen. Her mother and I do.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, for such an occasion, we say thank you. God, you knew in eternity past we would be in this place on this day, of this time of gathering. We thank you for your wisdom, and your guidance, and your providence that has brought us to this point. And God, we pray even now that the love of you, a God who is love, would fall fresh in this place and saturate not yet, not just this man, not just this woman, but all who are gathered in this sanctuary. Lord, saturate our hearts with your presence. Speak to our hearts today, God, that we might be reminded of just how much you love us. And we pray especially for this man and this woman that are being united today, that their hearts might be open to you, that they might be vessels through which your love is poured into and through, that they might share their lives with one another. Lord, may all that takes place today bring your name glory, honor, and praise. This we ask in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. It's in that name we pray. And all that were gathered together said, amen. Amen. Friends, loved ones of Micah and Adrian, we are gathered here before God and as witnesses to this occasion, where this man and this woman will be joined together in holy marriage. So this is a time of worship. For in fact, God himself is causing something sacred to happen as we gather in this place. I say to the two of you, marriage is an honorable and holy relationship created by God, and it symbolizes for us the mystical fellowship which exists between God and humanity. God is causing, again, something sacred to happen in this space. It is therefore not to be entered into lightly, not without advice, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear and love of Almighty God. I offer the both of you this charge. Micah, Adrian, I require and charge, as you stand in the presence of God and all of these assembled, that you have thoughtfully and prayerfully considered the holy covenant you're about to make to each other. God requires that you keep these vows, that you share between yourselves, as the Spirit in those vows will create joy and peace in your lives together. It will give strength to your home so that it shall abide through every unknown future. Micah, are you ready to affirm this whole relationship, to accept the responsibility of being a husband, to be loving, faithful, and helpful, whether in good days or difficult days? If so, please respond with the words, I am. And to you, Adrian, are you ready to affirm this holy relationship, to accept the responsibilities of being a wife, to be loving, faithful, and helpful, whether in good days or difficult days? If so, please respond with the words, I am. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, calm any fears and anxieties of Micah and Adrian as they stand here. Oh God, we pray your blessing on them in this high moment of their lives. Be near them, oh God, as they pledge their vows, that they may know full well the meaning of the words they promise. In your name we pray, amen.
Will you now join your right hands and repeat after me? I, Micah, take you, Adrian, to my lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, amen. Likewise, Adrian, will you repeat after me? I, Adrian, take you, Micah, to my lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, amen. Are there rings? Thank you. My, my. The ring is a circle. It is an emblem of eternity. It is to prove how lasting and imperishable the love that you now mutually pledge really is. As the union that is now formed is to be sundered only by death, it behooves you to understand the duties that you now solemnly assume. For if these duties be faithfully discharged, they will add to the blessedness of this life. But if these duties be neglected or violated, you cannot escape the keenest misery, as well as the most horrible guilt. Micah, it is the duty of the husband to provide for her, for his wife, and give to her a manly and unalterable affection, to provide for her support, to cherish for her an undying fidelity, and to see to it that what God joins together, human beings never put asunder. Adrian, it is the duty of the wife to reverence her husband and to put on the ornament of a meek spirit, which is, in God's sight, an ornament of great price. It being the command of God's word that wives be subject unto their own husbands, even as the church is subject unto Christ. It is the duty of you both to delight each in the society of the other, to remember that in interest, as well as in affection and reputation, you are to be henceforth one and undivided, to share one with another an unending and unbreakable bond, to ensure that what God joins together, no one can put asunder. Let's pray together. Gracious God, we thank you for these symbols of unbroken, unvarnished, untarnished consistency. We thank you for these rings that share with the world that love abides between this man and this woman. We pray now that as each gives and receives these rings, they will remember the love that they share one with another on this day. That love will be eternal, unbreakable. That love will show to the world what godly marriage should look like. Bless now as each gives and receives. In Jesus' name, amen. Michael, will you take this ring and place it on the left ring finger of your bride and repeat after me? As a pledge and in token of the vows between us made, with this ring I thee wed, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Adrian, will you place this ring on the left ring finger of your groom and repeat after me? As a pledge and in token of the vows between us made, with this ring I thee wed, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Before we came into this service, candles were lighted to my right to symbolize the families from which each of you has come. Those families love you very much. It's tried to instill a light in your lives to help you to shine brightly everywhere you go. Those lights are symbols of what has been begun in your lives. There is a candle in the center of those two lights. It is the symbol of what shall now be begun through the two of you as you join both hand and heart and become one flesh, one family. I'm going to ask that you will now take from those outer candles, which represents the families from which you have come, and light the center candle, the unity candle. We have learned from God's word that at the place of unity, God commands a blessing.
Thank you.
Said amen. Amen. This union is a special one, of course, to us, to fathers who have the privilege of sharing, officiating the union of their children, to mothers who lovingly sit before you, lighted those candles to symbolize the families from which you have come. We love you. We love you very much. The love that we have for you is not nearly as grand, as great, as the love our God has for you. That love was perfectly demonstrated through Jesus Christ, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And we're grateful today that we can remember that love. We can remember the reality that the Lord Jesus Christ paid an awesome sacrifice to save you, to redeem you. We are so excited that you have a relationship with that God through Jesus Christ. And now we remember what he has done for all of us, but especially for you. The elements of the Lord's Supper are here to remind us of that great sacrifice. As we partake, as you partake of these elements today, I ask that you take the bread that is a symbol of the broken body of Jesus Christ. Take of the wine that is a symbol of the shed blood of Jesus Christ. On this day, as you remember the love that you have for one another, never forget the love that our God has for you. As you remember it today, give thanks. The abundant life, the everlasting life that you enjoy is because of a great sacrifice paid at Calvary. As you remember Jesus Christ, the Savior of your lives, will you eat that bread, which is a symbol of his broken body? What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. That bread symbolizes that he was wounded for your transgressions and bruised for your iniquity. The chastisement of your peace was laid upon him, and with his stripes you've been healed. This wine now this is the symbol of that which has been shed for the remission of your sin. Thank God for Jesus washing all of our sins away. As you remember that, drink the wine in communion. With his power, he has raised me. To God be the glory. You may now rise from this kneeling bench. Are there any more songs that I don't know about? That's it. That means we've almost concluded our time here. I don't know how I feel about that. Feel some kind of way. I'm excited about your future. I'm excited about what God has for you. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. Hasn't even entered into your hearts. The things that God has prepared for you. So excited about what God has prepared for you. The providence of God has gone all the way down the corridor of your lives together, prepared great things for you. I'm excited about that. God says, I know the plans I have for you. God says those plans are to prosper you, not to harm you, to give you a future and a hope. And I thank God, we thank God, all of us thank God that we've been invited to see the commencement of those plans that God has for you. We've been invited into this space, this beautiful space, made holy by the presence of God, so that we could be witnesses to what God is beginning in your lives. Inasmuch as you have come into this place, you have consented to share vows one with another. You've exchanged rings one with another. You've decided to pledge your life, your love, your loyalty each to the other. It is with great delight that we, Pastor Richard Gaines and myself, announce that you are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. 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 Reverend Gaines. You may salute your bride. Look this way, let me bless you. Look this way. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace today, tomorrow, and forever, all the days of your life. In Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you now Reverend and Mrs. Micah Richard Gaines.